Good morning, everyone. This is Bob Dole from Solution Driven Wealth. Today is September 25th, 2020, and we're excited to have you for a part of our video series with Solution Driven Wealth. We have a lot of clients that are asking a lot of questions about the 2020 election. We thought it was very important to review some missteps that clients may make during this process. Our main concern is for the health and well-being of you and your family. Our entire staff cares about you tremendously. We care about not just your success financially, but also about the health and well-being of your families. One of the main questions that we get over this time period during presidential elections, should I do something? Should I panic if something goes against the party that I'm for? And we just want to let you know that we certainly manage money and have always managed money for clients, no matter what side of the political spectrum they come from. So our job is to manage money for you, specific to your needs, goals, and objectives. During prior recordings, we had thought and mentioned to you in those recordings that we felt that the presidential race was going to narrow, and it has considerably. And we expect that some of the polling data is probably not properly recording how close the race is in some key battleground states. So our point is to not be swayed too much by the news that you hear in terms of polling data. We do think that debates will matter in this election significantly. For the coronavirus reasons, the candidates have not been able to really be out there in front of people. And this is really some of the opportunities that both candidates will have to pit their ideas against one another. We'll expect that towards the end, just next week, there'll be a lot of talk about that first debate, and that's usually a crucial one. And then the follow-up debates, followed by the vice president debate coming up really in the first week of October. Clients ask us typically, what should they be doing after the election? What we try to tell clients is to remain calm and to stick to their plans and goals and objectives that we've set up during our prior meetings with them. Clients ask us, what if my candidate loses? What should I do? Well, again, we go back to the basics. What are your specific investment goals? There's a lot of news out there. There's few news programs anymore. Most of the programs out there, as we know, are opinion, both on one side or the other side of the ledger. What we would advise you is that the media is not your advisor. We know your goals and objectives. We have your best interests at hand. We are fiduciaries. We have to act in your best interest. And besides that, we have a personal relationship with you too. So again, try not to react to events in an emotional manner. This is a very interesting slide here in which it shows both the average annual return of the stock market on the left-hand side and the gross domestic product growth on the bottom hand of the legend. In most all presidential election periods, the market has gone up. Only two election periods was the market negative, and those were really due to asset bubbles, not necessarily caused by the candidates, but external moments in time that really pushed the market downward. But right now, actually, President Trump's stock market returns were a little bit higher due to the pandemic. They've come down a bit, but you can see during all those presidential periods, we've actually done quite well. What did we really learn from some of the data that we had today? Well, actually, during all presidential election cycles, it's normal for people to get nervous. The news media is kind of focused on the event and really pounding us with a lot of data. But when you actually get into the numbers, what's happened, both during Democratic and Republican administrations, the market has actually done well, except for two times in the last 50 to 60 years. Really, what we want to focus in on, your specific plan, your goals and objectives. Try not to react emotionally to market events or to presidential elections, and to stay the course into your specific plan. We want you to stay informed, and in the coming weeks, we'll be setting up review calls with you to review the third quarter results, also to focus on Q4 and 2021, if we can believe that, hopefully a better year for all of us in the future. We absolutely appreciate the opportunity to work with you. It's a privilege and an honor to work with our clients. We've never taken you for granted. If you have a question about your portfolio, a tact or a strategy that we're taking, tax questions, please reach out to us, and we're happy to respond to those inquiries, and we'll be talking to you real soon.